Hello guys, welcome back to Techdose, and in this video we will see the Boggle problem, which is given a dictionary of strings. We want to determine how many strings in a dictionary are present on a board. So let us look at the problem statement. The problem goes like this. Given a dictionary of words, that is, we are given a dictionary of strings, and we are also given a m by n board. So m by n is basically the dimension of this board, and each cell of this board is having one character. Now we can move to any of the 8 adjacent characters from a given position. So let's say we are at this position C, then we can move in all the 8 directions. So you can see that these 3 are basically empty because no characters are present here. So we can move in these directions only. So you can see that the diagonal elements are also adjacent to the current element. Now a word should not include multiple instances of the same cell. So let's say we want to find a word ABB, then you can see that we can start from this A and then go to B, but after going to this B, there is no other B adjacent to this B, so this word cannot be found. You can find either ABC, ABA, ABD or ABC. So these are the words which can be found by using AB in this instance. Now board can have multiple cells with the same character value. So you can see that A is also present at this location and A is present at this location. So these two cells are different, but they have the same character value. Now given the strings present in this dictionary, we want to determine how many of these strings can be formed on this board. So this is the entire problem. I hope you understood it. Now a very simple approach to solve this is, let us say we took a board, we are taking the same board, and our dictionary is containing 3 strings. So we will start with the first string. Now we can think of a recursive approach which will be applying the depth first search. Now if we start from this A, then we will have to search for this A on this entire board where A is present. So we are lucky that A is present at 0, 0. So we found A. Now from this A, we want to move to C. So we will move to C. Okay. And from this C, we want to move to D. So we will move to D. And how are we moving? Actually, when we are at this A, then we need to compare with all the 8 adjacent elements and see which one is equals to C. If there are multiple cases of C, then we will have to follow the recursive method like in a tree. That is, we will have to follow the backtracking approach. So in this case, you can see that there is only one C. So we will pick this path only. So from this C, there are many options, but then we want to search for D. And so we will go to D, and after going to this D, our string ends, so we will not take any other path, and this will be found. Now what will happen if you want to find ACA? Now we will start from this A, go to again this C, and from this C, we will compare in all the directions, and we will find an A which is to the left hand side of this C. But there was a constraint that we cannot include a single cell multiple times for the same string. So this was point number 4. So I hope you are understanding it. So for this reason, we need to mark the already visited cells. For that reason, I will take a visited array. This will keep track of all the nodes which are visited when we are traversing, that is when we are following a path. So in this case, when you start with A, then this will be made as true. When you go to C, this will also be made as true. Now while comparing to all the adjacent nodes, when we are comparing for a particular character, we will also see whether it has visited value of false or true. If it is true, then we will not visit it. Okay, so we will not consider it because that will give us the multiple instances of the same cell. So this ACA will not be found here. I hope you understood it. So in this way, you can apply the backtracking approach using the DFS. And what will be the time complexity of this algorithm? Actually, for each of this string, when you are at the first character, then you will have to search this first character throughout this board. And what is the size of this board? Size of this board is m into n, that is mn. And then for each of the string, you will have to search this first character, and then only from there you can flow this entire length of string and search in the adjacent cells. So this mn will be multiplied with number of strings. Because for each string, you will have to determine the first character position. and this will be added to the processing time of each string. So what is the processing time of each string? For each character in a string, you are comparing basically 8 different directions. So it will be 8 into number of characters in a string. So 8 into number of characters in longest string into number of strings. So I hope you are getting it, because we are basically finding the upper bound in this big O notation. So this is the total time complexity of the DFS approach. So let us now look at a better approach. A better approach can be, we will take the same board and we will also take the visited array, but then we will make use of this hash map. And why are we using this hash map? Because in the previous approach, we were searching for a character position by just traversing through this board. But if we use hash map, then it will be just done in O1 time. So now let's search for these three strings. Let's say our dictionary is having these three strings. So we will start from this A. Now, what will be the position of A and how will we find it? We will just subtract it with character A, and this will give us the value 0. So this A is basically the character value, which is C, and in this case it is A. A minus A will be 0. So we will go to the 0th location of the hash map, that is 0th index, and we will find the positions of A. So in this case, on this board there are two A's, so we will store it in a linked list. This is just to resolve collisions, as we do in the adjacency list when we solve the DFS approach in a graph. So I will post the link in the description below, you can check it out. I will assume that this first node is the required character, and so I will go to 0,0, this A. So this is just done in O1 time. Now I will assume that this string will be starting at this position only, and then traverse. And how will we traverse? We will traverse in the similar manner as we did in the DFS approach, but then we don't want to make 8 comparisons, that is on the 8 adjacent cells. What will we do is, we can just go to the hash map value, that is the next character is D, so we will go for D position. So D is actually stored at this 3rd index, we will go to 1,1. So we will assume that 1,1 is adjacent to it. And how will we compare? We can actually compare by checking the maximum of x1 minus x2 mod comma y1 minus y2 mod. So the maximum of the x or the y coordinate difference should be less than equals to 1. If this is true, then you can say that x1 comma y1 is adjacent to x2 comma y2. You can just try it with any points and this will always be true. So this is very simple and very logical, I hope. So you can see that when we move to 1,1, then this 0,0 is actually having a max difference value of 1 only, which is less than equals to 1, and so this will be adjacent. So we will move to this D. Now from this D, we want to find another D. And by the way, when we start moving, then we will make this true, because we cannot include a single cell more than once. So we want to move to D again, and the value of this D is again 3, so we will move to index 3, and this first one is already included. We move on to the second one, it is 2,2, and we can find that the current element index, which is 1,1, and this one 2,2, which we are comparing with, has a maximum value which is less than equals to 1. You can use this formula, and so it is adjacent. So 2,2 is adjacent to 1,1, so it is adjacent, and we move to D. We will also make it true. So we have confirmed ADD. Now we want to find E. Now from this position we want to find E. What is our current position? It's 2,2. Now we will go to the index of E. So index of E is 4. We go to 4, and so it is storing the coordinate 1,2. We go to coordinate 1,2. Before going, actually we can compare with the current index and see if the value difference is 1. So you can see that the max of x1 minus x2 comma y1 minus y2 is 1 actually, and that is less than equals to 1. This indicates that these two points are adjacent. So these points are adjacent and we have found E. So we'll go to E and make it true. So our string has ended. So we can say that this string is present on our board. So before moving on to the next string, we will have to make all these values false, because every time we check a string, we will have to refresh this entire visited array. So this can be done in just order of the previous string length time, because we will just go back in the reverse path. So this can be easily done by using recursion or something else if you can figure it out. Now we will see ACD. In the similar manner, you can see that we will start with A, we will go to this hashmap index 0, and we will start at 00, assuming that from 00 we can find ACD. So from 00 we will start this A. From this A, now we move on to C. Before moving on, we will make it true. Visited is true. We will move on to C. C is having index 2, so we will move on to index 2, and we will pick this first index 2, 0. So you can see that 2, 0 is this one, is this C, and this is 0, 0 currently. So if you take the max difference, then it will come out to be 2. So 2 is actually greater than 1, so it is not adjacent, and you can see in the figure that it is not adjacent. So we will not include this 2. Instead, we will move on to the next 2. It is at 0, 1. So this one is at 0, 1, and if you find the max difference of x and y, then it will come out to be 1. So these both are adjacent. So we move to this C. Now once we move to this C, we will make this value visited as true, and then from that C we want to move at D. So from here you can see that there is yet another D, and for moving on to that, we will have to go to its index D, which is at 3, at the third location 1, 1. So 1, 1 is adjacent to this 0, 1 by using this same formula. So we'll make this value true. Okay, I hope you are able to see it. This will be true, and then we will move to this one, this D. So ACD has now been covered, and so we can confirm that this dictionary word is actually present on our board. Now let's find this CC. So we'll start with the first C, and first C is at 2, 0. So we move to 2, 0. So this one is C. Now from this C, we need to find another C. This will be made as true. Now the index of C is again 2. So we will move on to this next 2, because we have already included this. So this 0, 1 is the next C, 0, 1. While comparing using this max formula, you will find that these both are not adjacent, so you cannot include it. Now we want to try with next C. So there is no next C. So this is not possible, and so we can confirm that this dictionary word is not present on our board. So I hope you are able to understand how can we find whether a given string is present on our board or not by using this hash map. So you can see that this hash map will improve your time complexity as compared to your simple DFS approach, because on the simple approach, for the first character of a string, you were actually traversing this entire board. You can actually use a hash map so that you can improve the time complexity. But then here you can improve the time complexity by using hash map, and then while searching as well, you don't need to compare with all the 8 adjacent cells, but then you can just make use of the hash map, or you can use these 8 comparisons. It will just be a constant time, both will be similar. Okay, so let us look at the time complexity of this algorithm. For this algorithm, if you take a string, then you will flow through this string only once, and each of the character is only taking O one time, considering that this hash map is taking O one time for accessing the character on a board. So what will be the time complexity? The time complexity will be sum of all characters of all the words, because we have assumed that each of the character can be found in just O one time using the hash map. So this hash map will actually deteriorate depending on the number of characters which are same. So if you have a large board and many characters are same, then you might have to traverse through a list linearly, and this may not be O1 time, but we will assume that it is O1 because it is very less likely to have so many repeating characters on a board. So considering that, this approach will be better than the DFS approach. And there is yet another approach, which is by using try, but then the time complexity of try as well as this simple approach is same. So I have not explained it, and this hash map is actually giving the best performance out of these three. So if there are many repeating characters, then the difference in time between this better approach and simple approach will decrease. But then again, this simple approach is done by using recursion. So recursion is having its own overheads, and it will take a lot of time. But if you can implement it by using a for loop or a while loop, then this will run way much faster than a recursion program. So I hope you are able to understand this code. The code for the simple approach will be given in the description section below, so do check it out. If you have any type of doubt, then feel free to comment below and I'll try to help you as soon as possible. Like and share our video and subscribe to our channel in order to watch more of this programming video. See you in our next video. Thank you.